have cleared the tower. The spacecraft is on its way to Saturn.
Cassini nearly out of propellant, 1% of the propellant left, plus or minus 2%. We can't risk Cassini becoming a piece of space junk around Saturn that could end up crashing into one of a few Saturn moons that apparently have liquid water environments, just a perfect breeding ground for life. So we cannot risk contaminating those moons with earthbound bacterial spores. We have to preserve those worlds for future exploration. On September 11th, 2017, we'll do about 120,000 kilometer flyby of Titan. That's close enough. Titan's gravity is going to nudge us, and that nudge will lower our closest approach to Saturn to a point that's within Saturn's atmosphere. So from that point forward, we only have about half of an orbit. The very last full day of the mission, which is the 14th, rather than focus on one target or another, we're giving every scientific discipline a chance to say goodbye. So we have the last Titan picture, the last Enceladus picture. If you're moving out of a house you've been in for decades, you might want to take one last walk through the house and say goodbye to each room and the memories that you had in those rooms. So that's what we're doing. So by the morning of September 15th, we'll reconfigure the spacecraft to actually become a real-time data collector and sender, a task for which it was never designed. About 1:37 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time, we'll begin a five-minute roll. We'll roll the spacecraft to put INMS, the ion and neutral mass spectrometer, in a good direction to sniff the atmosphere of Saturn. A little over 3 hours later, we'll enter the atmosphere and the thrusters will start firing to counterbalance the torques from the atmosphere. And this is the key moment where we're sniffing Saturn's upper atmosphere for the first time. The amazing thing is that out of our 12 science instruments on board, everything but the cameras basically are taking data. And we hope to take data literally up to the last second. But at some point, the atmosphere wins, and the thrusters, even firing 100% of the time, can't overcome that torque. So the spacecraft will essentially point away from the Earth, and at that point, we can't maintain high-gain data and get a signal. From when we first start measuring the atmosphere until we no longer communicate with the spacecraft, that's essentially 1 to 2 minutes. In a way, maybe it's better that we don't see what happens next. We're screaming in at 76,000 miles per hour. The fact we're going so fast makes a lot of atmospheric friction and heat, and that heat is what melts and then vaporizes the spacecraft. Essentially, there's different parts of the spacecraft that have different melting points. The thermal blankets will burn off first, and then aluminum will start to melt. So all those molecules for our earthbound emissary are then part permanently of Saturn's atmosphere. A real ashes to ashes and dust to dust story for Cassini.